Hello, this is Cristi. In this video, I'm going to show you a feature that was introduced in Camtasia 2022, and you need version 2022.1 to have this feature. It's been a feature that was requested for many years from many users of Camtasia, and that is to reverse a video. And I'm not going to tell you today to cut the video into individual frames and move them one by one to the other end of the video to reverse it, or to use an external program, because this is now in Camtasia. Maybe TechSmiths have had enough of people asking for this feature. So there you go, they caved. So now we have this feature. So let me show you how it works. It doesn't work in real time like other programs do it, but it actually creates a second copy of the video. So here's my project. I have a video of a boat coming into a harbor. I'm going to silence the audio for this. We don't need it. So as you can see, this boat is coming into the harbor right there. So it works that way. Now, with the reverse function, you can't actually right click and reverse a clip on the timeline in place. So I'm going to show you how you can work around that now. You can only do it in the media bin. So if you see this video clip in the media bin right here, it's like 51 seconds long. If I right click on this clip, you have the option now to reverse video. And that's going to take a while. If you click reverse video, you can see that it actually creates a copy of that video reversed. And it says one there because I've already done it as a test, and it keeps that copy, and it creates yet another one in the temporary folder somewhere. So you can cancel this while it's doing it. It takes a while. It's almost the same maybe as creating a proxy, I guess, you know, which is an operation. You also do it in the media bin right there. So when it's finished, here we go. I can place this on my timeline right there. And if I play it now, you can see that it is going backwards, right? Now, one thing that this doesn't do, it doesn't reverse the audio. And because my video had the audio, actually, this one doesn't have audio. So if you need the audio, you need to separate the audio and kind of keep it, I suppose. So there you have it. The video is playing backwards. Now, if you need to replace this video in place, so let's say that you have a video that's playing forward normally, and you need to replace it, the only way to do it is to select your clip in the timeline and right-click on the reversed copy in here, and you can say replace selected media on timeline, and you have your options there. Ripple replace, replace from start, from end, whatever, depending on if you made any cuts to it or how you want it to fit. So I would say just replace from start, because if it's the same length, it's gonna keep it in place. If you have actually made cuts to it, you will have to choose either ripple replace, which is gonna maybe make room for it, or I'm not sure if that's actually replace with clip speed will make it fit in the space that it has available. So ripple replace. There we go. My clip has been replaced. So now the clip is in the same place, but it's playing backwards. And of course, you can apply proxy to these videos because it's basically just another video now in your media bin. You still keep the original one. You can right click and create proxy video for it so that it moves faster in editing and so on, just like any other clip you used to have. Well, so this is kind of more than halfway there. I mean, the reverse function is definitely something that a lot of people have asked for, and now you have it, even though that actually creates a copy of the clip. Whereas in other programs, I believe they just do it in place, which might require a more performant engine of playback to allow you to play them in, you know, at the real speed in reverse as well as playing forward. So there's a lot of implications there. But at least this is good because we don't have to resort to other external solutions for reversing video if we really need. I personally don't need a lot of this function. I can't really... I don't edit the types of videos that require reversing so much. So yeah, but if you need it, it's now, again, it's in Camtasia 2022.1. So Camtasia 2022 released in July 2022. And since then, there have been several updates. And this is one of them that introduces this feature and two more, which I have separate videos for those as well. So thank you for watching. If you enjoy my videos, I would appreciate if you like the subscribe and share my videos. And, you know, it really helps if you click that like button and maybe the bell icon to be notified of new videos. And yeah, check out the description below for more Camtasia videos and feel free to ask any questions. If you have any questions about Camtasia, about Descript and any other things that I show on my channel, happy to help. Thank you and see you on the next one.